गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग। ओके, लेट अस टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ न्यू टॉपिक मार्कोव चेन्स। ओके, नाउ बिफोर वी स्टार्ट विद मार्कोव चेन, लेट्स रिफ्रेश द नॉलेज अबाउट मैट्रिक्स। ओके, एनी आइडिया अबाउट मैट्रिक्स एंड मैट्रिक्स मल्टीप्लिकेशन? कुछ आइडिया है?
No, sir, I don't know.
Basically, the matrix is a rectangular array of numbers. Okay. For example, 1, 2, 3, 2, -1, 5, okay, etc. Okay. So this is called as a matrix. So basically, matrix is what? It is a rectangular arrangement or rectangular array of numbers. Numbers may be integers, may be natural number, may be fraction, or may be a real number. Fine. Now, when we say that it is a rectangular array of numbers, it means that numbers are arranged in rows and columns. Okay. Now, see, this is called as a row. This is second row. Similarly, this is first column, second column, and third column. Okay. Now, so this particular matrix has two rows and three columns. Okay, so the order of this matrix is said to be 2 by 3. Okay, so the first member of this product represent number of rows and second represent number of columns. Okay. Now you may have a matrix of order of row 1, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so what would be order of this matrix? So here we have only one row and three columns, so order of this matrix is 1 by 3. Or one may have a matrix like 2, -1, 10. Okay, now in this particular matrix there are three rows and only one column, so order of this matrix is 3 by 1. Okay. Now, like you can construct any matrix of any order, right? In general, order of matrix is denoted by M by N, where M stands for number of rows and N stands for number of columns. Okay. Ab basic operations main yahan pe repeat nahi karunga because algebra of matrices, usme kya hota hai ki addition of matrices, then subtraction of matrices, okay, and third operation is multiplication of matrices. Okay. In our or this particular chapter requires the prerequisite knowledge about the matrix multiplication, so we'll focus on matrix multiplication only. Okay. Now the primary condition for multiplication to happen is the number of rows in the first matrix, sorry, number of columns in the first matrix should be equal to number of rows in the second matrix. Okay. For example, if first matrix have three rows, two rows and three columns, say 1, 2, 3, then say 5, 0, 1 is the first matrix of order 2 by 3. And second matrix has three rows and two columns. Okay. Say 2, 4, 6, 0, 1, and 5. Okay. Now, what is order of this matrix? Order is 3 by 2. Okay. Now, to find product of these two matrices, what we'll do? For first matrix, we'll go row wise, and for second matrix, we'll go column wise. Okay. So, the product of the matrix would be 2 by 2. Okay. Now, this multiplication is possible only if the number of columns in the first matrix is equals to the number of rows in the second matrix. Okay. See here, first matrix has three rows, three columns, and second matrix has three rows. So here, matrix multiplication is possible. Okay. And the order of the product matrix would be 2 by 2. Okay. This 2 So in product of these two matrices, there will be two rows and two columns. Okay. So order of this product matrix would be 2 by 2. Now to find product, what we'll do? The product of these two matrices will be 1 into 2 plus 2 into 4 plus 3 into 6. 1 into 2 plus 2 into 4 plus 3 into 6. Okay. This will be 1-1 element. Okay. Or I'll denote it as A11. A11 means what? See, yahan pe do suffix hai. 1. So the first member, 1, represent row. And this, so A12 matlab kya hoga? It would be a number in the first row and second column. This is a number in first row and first column. Aij, in general, Aij is what? A number in ith row and jth column, right? So A11 element of product matrix would be 1 into 2 plus 2 into 4 plus 3 into 6. Similarly, A12 element would be the first row of first matrix and second column of second matrix. Okay. See, now I'm calculating A12. So, what will we do? We'll consider first row of matrix A. Let us suppose that this is matrix A and this is matrix B. Okay. And second column of matrix B. So you can have a 1 into 0 plus 2 into 1 plus 3 into 5. 1 into 0 plus 2 into 1 plus 3 into 5. Okay. 3 into 5. Similarly, to calculate this element, A21. What this would be? A21. Now to calculate A21, what we'll do, we'll consider second row of matrix A and first column of matrix B. So ye kya hoga? A21. 5 into 2 plus 0 into 4 plus 6 into 1. Okay, directly likh do main. 5 into 2 is 10 plus 0 plus 6. Similarly, what is this element? A22. So for this element, we'll consider second row of first matrix and second column of matrix B. So 5 into 0, 0, plus 0 into 1 is 0, plus 1 into 5. Okay. So this number would be 5. So 2 plus 8 is 10, 10 plus 18 is 28. So here we get 28. 0 plus 2 plus 15 is 17. Okay, and here ho jayega 16. Fine. Okay. Ye samajh mein aa gaya process? Now suppose we want to find B into A. Okay, see, this is what? A into B. What is order of A into B? Order of A into B is 2 by 2. Fine. Now if we want to find B into A, main matrix yahan pe fir se copy karta hu. 2, 4, 6, 0, 1, and 5. Okay. Now, what is order of this matrix? It's 3 by 2. Order of matrix A is 2 by 3. Okay. Now, here both A multiplied by B and B multiplied by A are possible, right? Because number of columns in the first matrix is 2, 1, 2. Which is same as the number of rows in the second matrix. Okay. 2. So here, multiplication of matrices ABA, B multiplied by A is possible. And what would be the order of this matrix? Order of matrix B multiplied by A will be 3 by 3. Okay. Ab yahan pe element kya honge? A11. A12, A13, then A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, and A33. Okay. So there will be 9 elements in the product B cross A. Now let's calculate A11, A12, etc. Now A11 kya hoga? Now here for matrix B will go row wise and for matrix A will go column wise. So A11 matlab first row of matrix B and first column of matrix A. Okay. So A11 is 2 into 1 plus 0 into 5, that is 2. So this value would be 2. Okay. Then A12 for this element will consider first row of B and second column of A. 2 into 2, 4, 0 into 0, 0. So this element ho jayega aapka 4. Okay. Then for this element, first row of matrix B and third column of matrix A. So 2 into 3, 6 plus 0 is 6. So A, this element would be 6. Now second row, A21. Now for this, we'll consider second row of matrix B and first column of matrix A. So 4 into 1 plus 5 into 1 is 9. So ye number ho jayega aapka 9. Then iske liye kya karenge? Second row, second column, 4 2 za 8 plus 0, 8. Okay. Then 4 3 za 12 plus 1, 13. Okay. Next, 6 1 za 6 plus 5 5 za 25. So, you will get 31. This number would be 31. Okay. Then 12 plus 0 is 12. 6 is 18 plus 5 is 23. Okay. Now, clearly, this is a matrix. See, A by B. A multiply by B. A multiply by B is a matrix of order 2 by 2. And B multiply by A is a matrix of order 3 by 3. So, clearly, A multiply by B is not equals to B multiply by A. Okay. So ye both important property. For any set, let it be natural numbers or integers or real numbers or complex number, multiplication is commutative. So A multiply by B is same as B multiply by A. For example, 2 multiply by 3 is same as 3 multiply by 2. So this property is called as commutative property. So normal multiplication is a commutative operation, but matrix multiplication is not commutative. See, A multiplied by B is not equals to B multiplied by A. So be careful while calculating the probabilities, because here order is very important. Okay. In which order you are multiplying the matrices is very important, right? Ulta nahi chalega, right? So you may lead to wrong result. ये समझ में आ गया कंसेप्ट मैट्रिक्स मल्टीप्लिकेशन का?
यस सर.
ओके, लेट्स मूव टू आवर मेन टॉपिक, मार्कोव चेन्स. ओके, सो बेसिकली मार्कोव चेन इज अ प्रोसेस. मार्कोव चेन और मार्कोव प्रोसेस इज अ प्रोबेबिलिस्टिक मॉडल. ओके, नाउ बाय प्रोबेबिलिस्टिक मॉडल व्हाट डू आई मीन? इट इज अ मैथमेटिकल सिस्टम based on some probability rules. Okay. Now it is a basically it is a probabilistic model that gives transition from one state to another. Okay. And the basic assumption of Markov chain is no matter how we arrive at present state, the state probabilities of future state is based on the current state. Okay. For example, see, after independence, we have observed various parties forming central government. Okay, since 1947. Okay, now if let us suppose that our the current government is of NDA. Okay, so this is what present state. Now, next election are going to happen in 2024. Okay. Now it is quite possible that in the next state, NDA will form a government, or UPA will form a government, or maybe third front. Okay. See, the present state is NDA. Now, the chances of NDA to form a government, or UPA to form a government, or third front to form a government in 2024 does not depend on the previous. Okay. It depends on this state only. Okay. Like how NDA perform during next 4 years, the chances of forming NDA or UPA or third front government in 2024 depends on the performance of NDA. Okay. So it depends. So future state depends on the current state only. इसके पहले कांग्रेस ने क्या किया इसके ऊपर कोई बेस नहीं है राइट सो दिस इज द बेसिक अजम्पशन इन द मार्को चेन द मार्को चेन कैन बी एक्सप्लेन विद हेल्प और बाय एन एग्जांपल आई एक्सप्लेन मार्को चेन बाय कंसीडरिंग द बेबीज बिहेवियर ओके सपोज अ स्मॉल चाइल्ड इज प्लेइंग विद फोर टॉयज से ए बी सी एंड डी Okay, and let's suppose that presently he is playing with A, toy A. Okay, now can we say that after 5 minutes he will be playing with toy A? Not necessary, right? So he may continue playing with toy A, or that baby will switch to toy B, or to toy C, or to toy D. Okay, or he may continue playing with toy A. Similarly, if in current state the baby is playing with toy B, then after 5 minutes he may continue playing with B, or he may switch to A, or to C, or to D. Okay. Similarly, if baby is playing with toy C, then he may continue with C, or he may switch to B, or he may switch to A, or he may switch to D. Okay. Now, suppose that 5 minutes ago, the baby is playing with toy C. Okay. Now, it does not have any impact on the switching behavior of the baby. Okay. Now, if the baby see, it present state, 5 minutes ago, he is playing with toy C. And currently, he is playing with toy A. Now, from toy A, the baby may switch to B or C or D, or he may continue playing with toy A. Now, the switching behavior is not dependent on C. Or 10 minutes ago, suppose baby is playing with D. Okay. Now, the behavior of switching or hopping from toy A to any other toy does not depend on previous states. Okay, so this is the basic assumption of the Markov chain. Okay, it does not consider the previous states. Okay, so this is called as a stochastic process. So basically, Markov chain follow stochastic process. Stochastics matlab kya hai? It does not consider previous states. So the future state, stochastic process means what? Future states depends on the present state only. Okay, not past states. Okay, so this is the basic assumption of Markov chain. Okay. Now let us suppose that there are only two possibilities, say state A and state B. And further, let us suppose that at present, the system is in state A. Okay. Now, in next period, see, the period may be of 5 minutes or 10 minutes or 1 minute or 5 years. जो मैंने government का example दिया था उसमें period कितना लिया? I have considered 5 years. Baby का switching behavior के लिए I have considered 5 minutes. Okay. So period कुछ भी हो सकता है. So the time after a gap of a period, it's called as a state. Okay. So current state is denoted by n equal to 0. Okay. Suppose a period is of 1 year. Then the future after 1 year, it's called as state n equal to 1. Future after 2 years is called as second state, and so on.
Okay.
Now suppose that in second state, the probability of continuing with state A is say 0.6, and probability that system will switch from state A to state B with probability 0.4. Okay. Further, let us suppose that if we are in state B, then probability of switching to A is say 0.5, and probability of continuing with B is 0.5. Okay. So yahan pe wahi hoga 0.6. A to A probability kya hai? 0.6. And A to B ki probability hai, suppose 0.4. Okay. So this is state n equal to 2 or second state. Okay. Now,
sir, excuse me, sir. So your video is stuck, sir.
Acha. That's okay.
Frozen.
Just a minute. अच्छा मतलब ये कुछ आपको समझ में नहीं आ गया. ओके सपोज दैट द प्रेजेंट स्टेट मतलब n इक्वल टू 0 एट प्रेजेंट स्टेट द सिस्टम इज इन स्टेट ए. ओके नाउ ए टू बी सॉरी ए टू ए और इफ इन द नेक्स्ट पीरियड इफ सिस्टम कंटिन्यूज विथ स्टेट ए विथ प्रोबेबिलिटी 0.6 एंड probability of switching from A to B is say 0.4. Let us assume this. Okay. Abhi ho gaya after one period. Now, after second period, kya ho sakta hai? A to A again same probability there, 0.6 and 0.4. B to A ki probability, let us assume 0.5, and B to B probability, again, obviously it is 0.5. Okay. Now, the question is, if the present state is say A, present state is A, then what would be the probability that after two periods, the system will be in state B? Okay. See, अब यहाँ पे देखो system B में कहाँ पे है? यहाँ पे है और यहाँ पे. Means we want to calculate the probability that system will be in state B after two period. Okay. What will be this probability? 0.6 into 0.4, right? 0.6 into 0.4. Or, okay, either ye happen ho sakta hai, either this path will happen or this path will happen. Now, probability of this path is 0.6 into 0.4 because it is sequence of event and sequence of independent event, in fact. Okay. So, probability of happening of this is probability of this plus probability of this, that is 0.6 into 0.4. Or what is probability of this? Or matlab addition aa gaya, what is probability of this? 0.4 into 0.5. okay, see here we are assuming that presently the system is in state.
Actually, I didn't get that 0.6 into 0.4.
नहीं नहीं हमने assume किया है. See, अगर दो ही state हमें assume करके चल रहे हैं, okay? State A and state B. Okay. Now, after one period, जैसे हमने three governments लिए थे, NDA, UPA and Third Front. Okay. अब 2024 में NDA भी हो सकता है, NDA में form government again, or UPA will form government, or Third Front will form a government. Okay. Now, अब वो uncertain है. Uncertainty मतलब क्या है? Chances है. Okay. Let us suppose that the chances that NDA will form government again in 2024 is 70%. मतलब इसकी probability क्या हो गई? 0.7. Okay. UPA will form a government, suppose probability is 25% of 0.25, and Third Front will form a government in 2024 is say 5%, that is 0.05. okay, so yeah, because future is uncertain, so the chances of switching from one state to another state is associated with some probability, right? That is why the Markov chain is a call it as a probabilistic model. Okay? Now, with the help of these probabilities, we'll predict the future. Okay. एक और एग्जांपल मैं बाद में डिस्कस करता हूँ. लेट्स एक कंसेप्ट में यहाँ पे लेट मी कवर दिस कंसेप्ट. फाइन. सिमिलरली हियर आई हैव अज्यूम्ड दैट दिस इज बेसिकली माय अजम्पशन. इट इज नॉट बेस्ड ऑन एनी प्रीवियस एक्सपीरियंस. सो लेट अस अज्यूम दैट इफ प्रेजेंटली वी आर इन स्टेट ए, देन द प्रोबेबिलिटी दैट इन नेक्स्ट पीरियड विल बी इन स्टेट ए is 0.06, and state A to state B ke switching probability is 0.4. Again, wahi probability yahan pe continue hai because A to A, because right now we are in state A after one period. So after two periods, A to A jane ki probability hai 0.6, A to B jane ki probability hai 0.4. Okay, B to A 0.5, B to B 0.5. Okay. So if we are in state A, then the probability that after two periods we will be in probability we will be in state B is 0.6 × 0.4 + 0.4 × 0.5. okay, now the question arises, matlab ye kya ho gaya, A to B after two periods, huh? Okay, now what will be the probability of A to A की प्रोबेबिलिटी क्या होगी? 0.6 × 0.6 + 0.4 × 0.5, right? Now similarly, if presently we are in state B, okay, then ये क्या हो जाएगा यहां पे? फाइन. बी टू ए जाने की प्रोबेबिलिटी क्या है? 0.5. बी टू बी की प्रोबेबिलिटी है 0.5. फाइन. नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट वुड बी द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ बी टू ए? व्हाट वुड बी द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ बी टू ए? क्या होगी? 0.5 × 0.6 ओके, और 0.5 × 0.5. B2B की प्रोबेबिलिटी क्या होगी? 0.5 × 0.4 + 0.5 × 0.5, राइट? नाउ okay, now these probabilities can be obtained by matrix multiplication. Okay, see, basically ye kya ho gaya, a b a b a. See, ab main yahan pe after two periods calculation kar raha hu, thoda sa main matrix bada nikalta hu. Now a to a ki probability kya hai? A to a 0.6 × 0.6 + 0.5 × 0.5. A to B की प्रोबेबिलिटी है 0.6 × 0.4 + 0.4 × 0.5. Then B to A 0.5 × 0.6 + 0.5 × 0.5. Similarly, others. Okay. Now, actually, this matrix is nothing but the multiplication of two matrices. Okay. See, verify bhi kar sakte. ये क्या होगा? 0.6 × 0.6 + 0.4 × 0.5, करेक्ट? 0.6 × 0.4 + 0.4 × 0.5 + this matrix would be this element would be 0.5 into 0.6 plus 0.5 into 0.5. This element would be 0.5 into 0.4 plus 0.5 into 0.4. Okay. So if we want to calculate the probabilities after n period, probabilities of occurrence of any particular state after n periods, then kya karna hai? We will successively multiply the matrices. Matlab, suppose I want to find probabilities of states after one period, then I'll multiply the state probability or present state with this matrix only once. If I want to calculate probabilities after two periods, do bar main multiply hunga. If I want to calculate probabilities after three periods, I'll multiply this matrix three times. Okay. Actually, this matrix is called as a transition matrix, transition probability matrix. Okay. Ek aur example main explain karta hun. Okay. Or same, I'll represent with another diagram. Suppose we have only two states, A and B. Okay. Now, probability of switching from A to B is 0.4. Okay. And probability of retention of A is 0.6. Matlab A to A ki probability humne kitni li thi? 0.6. A to B ki probability kitni li thi? 0.4. Similarly, B to B, we have assumed 0.5 and this as 0.5. Now, these probabilities are called as transition probabilities, transition or hopping probabilities or switching probabilities. Okay. But we use term transition probability. Okay. And iska jo matrix hai, matlab yahan pe in general, Pij, what Pij represent? If currently we are in ith state, then the probability of switching from ith state to jth state is generated by Pij. Okay. And this matrix, matlab P11, P12, P21, P22. This matrix is called as transition probability matrix. Okay. Now, ye matrix both important hai to calculate the probabilities. Okay. Ab iske, there are multiple applications. Ab kuch concept hai. Maine notes share kiya aapse. Definitions are given in the notes itself. Formal definition I'm not going to cover in this session. Sirf main aapko explain karunga what is concept. Okay. Now, next concept to be discussed is present state probabilities. Okay. Or it is also called as initial condition. Let me give one example. If we collect data from say 1,000 students about what brand of mobile handset they are using. Okay. Further, let us suppose that there are three brands. One is Samsung, second is Apple, and ek kaam karte, third category hum combine karte, say others. Okay. Now, let us suppose that presently 30% students are using Samsung mobile, 20% are using Apple, and 50% are using other brand. Okay. Matlab probabilities kya ho gayi? 0.3, 0.2, and 0.5. Okay. Now, this is called as initial condition. Okay. This is called as initial condition, and it is denoted by R0. Okay. Initial condition is denoted by R0. Means what? The state probabilities after zero period. After zero period, matlab abhi, present situation. Okay. So present situation is denoted by R0. Actually, it represents the chances of occurrence of state A or B or C respectively in the present state. Okay. So it means that if we pick one student randomly, then the probability that he is using Samsung mobile is 0.3. Okay. He is using Apple handset is 0.2 and other brand 0.5. Okay. Now, if we calculate, if we collect data after say 1 year from same 1,000 students. Okay. Now, can we say that after 1 year, the data or the percentage of three brands will be same? Okay. Obviously not. Okay. Now, why? Because some of the customers or some of the students using Samsung may switch to Apple or other brand. Okay. Or some customer may continue with the same brand, same Samsung brand. Okay. Similarly, Apple ke bhi kuch customer retain honge. Apple may lose some customers to Samsung or Apple may lose some customers to others. Okay. Similarly, other wale kuch retain ho jayenge. Some customer using other brand may switch to Apple brand or may switch to Samsung brand. Okay. So, ye yahan pe transition ho gaya. Now, what is present state? Present state is 0.3, 0.2 and 0.5. Okay. Now, suppose this switching or chances of switching, you know. So, let us suppose that Samsung is able to retain 70% of its customer. So, probability of retention is retention for Samsung brand is 0.7. Let's suppose that probability of switching Samsung to Apple is 0.2. Okay. And probability of switching Samsung to other is 0.1. Okay. Similarly, let us suppose that Apple is successful in retaining 80% of the customer. So, its probability kya hogi retention ki 8%. Switching ki ho gai, suppose 0.08 and 0.15, 15% Apple customer switch to Samsung and 5% switch to other brand. Okay. Other ki bhi suppose aisa assume karte 50% 0.3 and ye ho gaye 0.2. Now these values are actually transition probabilities. Now, with the help of this, these probabilities, we can create a transition probability matrix. Okay. Samsung, Apple, others. Samsung, Apple, and others. Okay. Now, what is retention probability of Samsung? Is 0.7. Samsung to Apple, switching probability is 0.2. Samsung to other, 0.1. Okay. Similarly, Apple to Samsung kitna hai? 0.15, Apple to Apple 0.8 and Apple to others 0.05. Okay. Then others ke liye kya hai? Retention is 0.2 hai. Okay, others to Samsung, na? Okay. Now, ek cheez yahan pe, I request you to note down one important thing, because this row represent this diagonal values represent retention probabilities, and these two values represent lose to probabilities. Okay, so Samsung is losing 20% customer to Apple, and Samsung is losing 10% customers to other. Okay. Now, the total probability is 1 or 100%. Okay. So, if you take sum of all elements in a row, it will be always equal to 1. Okay. वैसे column के case में नहीं है. Okay. यहाँ पे क्या होगा total? Total row total will be 1. Fine. But column total may be 1 or may not be 1. Okay. Now, एक चीज यहां पे आप नोटिस कर सकते हो. सी इफ वी टेक टोटल कॉलम टोटल यहां पे क्या होगा 0.7 प्लस 2 इज 9.9 प्लस 1 105. इसका मतलब क्या है? Samsung इज एक्चुअली गेनिंग कस्टमर. ओके. सिमिलरली इसका भी गेन हो रहा है एंड इसका अदर ब्रांड का बहुत लॉस हो रहा है, राइट? Must other brand is able to, or if the market share of, if we assume that the current market share of other brand is 100, then in next period, the share would be 65%. Okay, it means that other brand is losing 35 customers to other two brands, Samsung or Apple. Okay, on the other hand, Samsung is successful in gaining 5% of the customer than the previous period, and Apple is successful in gaining 30% of new customers. Okay, fine. Now, suppose we want to find the market share after one period. Okay, so market share after one period is generated by R1. Okay, R0 kya hai? Is initial condition or state probabilities after zero period. Okay, this is state probabilities after period one. Okay, now to calculate R1, what we'll do, we'll simply multiply R0 into matrix P. Okay, this matrix P is called as transition state matrix. Okay, similarly, suppose we want to calculate R2. Fine. Means what? State probabilities after second period. So isko kya karenge hum? We'll simply multiply R1 by matrix P. Okay, because R2 depends on R1. R3 depends on R2. Okay. In general, if you want to calculate Rn, okay, state probabilities after n periods, then hum kya karenge? We'll multiply, post multiply matrix P to state probabilities after n minus 1 periods. Okay, so this is called as nth state probabilities, and this is called as zeroth state probability or initial condition. Right? Concept samajh mein aa gaya? Yahan pe teen cheez, do cheeze important hai. First is to calculate initial condition, second to calculate transition probability matrix. Okay, now this type of information aapko provide kiya jayega in example. Okay, initial condition will also,
so we can't hear you, sir.
Using initial condition and transition state probabilities, we can find state probabilities after any period, maybe 1 period, 2 period, 3 period, etc. Okay. Uske liye kya karna hai aapko? Simply multiply karte jana hai with transition state probability. So if you want to calculate R2, so pehle hum kya karenge? First we'll calculate R1. Okay, and for that we'll simply post multiply matrix P to R0. Okay. Note that यहाँ पे उल्टा नहीं चलेगा, right? Order is this because matrix multiplication is non-commutative operation. So you cannot do P into R0. Opposite नहीं हो पाएगा. In fact, it is not possible to multiply because order of R0 would be, in this case, R0 is 1/3 matrix, one row and 3 columns. Whereas P is what? It is a 3/3 matrix, right? So आपका ये है P 3/3 मैट्रिक्स एंड R0 है 1/3 मैट्रिक्स. ओके, सी मैट्रिक्स मल्टीप्लिकेशन इज पॉसिबल ओनली इफ नंबर ऑफ कॉलम्स इन द फर्स्ट मैट्रिक्स इज इक्वल टू नंबर ऑफ रोज. यहाँ पे इक्वल नहीं है. देयर इज ओनली वन रो इन R0 एंड 3 कॉलम्स इन P. सो P इनटू R0 इज नॉट पॉसिबल. सो लिखते वक्त भी बी केयरफुल, उल्टा मत लिखो. ओके, दो इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल बट मतलब मल्टीप्लिकेशन होगा ही नहीं, बट मेनी टाइम स्टूडेंट क्या करते हैं, ऐसा उल्टा लिखते हैं. सो बी केयरफुल, आपके मार्क्स यहाँ पे कट सकते हैं. फाइन, नाउ लेट्स डिस्कस न्यूमेरिकल्स. ये कंसेप्ट थोड़ा सा आपको फिर से पढ़ो एक बार, अदरवाइज न्यूमेरिकल्स बहुत ईजी है, ज्यादा कुछ डिफिकल्ट नहीं है. ओनली आपको मैट्रिक्स मल्टीप्लिकेशन करना है, दैट्स इट. ओके, लेट्स डिस्कस सम क्वेश्चंस. आई हैव शेयर्ड PDF फाइल ऑफ दिस चैप्टर today morning, so I request all of you to download so that Okay, now let's discuss example number one. डाउनलोड कर लिया आपने? ठीक है.
Yes, sir. So you've put in general. So.
अच्छा, general में डाला है क्या? Okay. ठीक है, मैं उसमें डाल देता हूँ. After the station, I'll.
No, I mean the students can be looking it for it in different science senses.
Okay. Huh. ओके ठीक है. क्वेश्चन में डिक्टेट करता हूँ. टू ट्रेडर्स ए एंड बी आर ट्रेडिंग इन अ कॉम्पिटेटिव मार्केट. ट्रेडर ए इज लकी टू रिटेन हिज कस्टमर्स 70% ऑफ द टाइम एंड ऑल्सो इन अट्रैक्टिंग 40% ऑफ कस्टमर्स ऑफ हिज कॉम्पिटिटर. ओके, कंस्ट्रक्ट एंड इंटरप्रेट द ट्रांजिशन प्रोबेबिलिटी मैट्रिक्स इन टर्म्स ऑफ रिटेंशन एंड लॉस. Okay, and or retention and gain. Okay. Now, यहाँ पे दो traders हैं, trader A and trader B. Now, trader A is successful in retaining 70% of its customers. मतलब retention probability. See, diagonal element represent retention probabilities. तो ये क्या होगी? 0.7. So probability that customer of trader A again purchase in the next period from A will be 0.7. Okay. Matlab 70% retain kar raha hai. It means that trader A is losing 30% of its customer. So this probability must be 0.3. Okay. Now it is also given that trader A is successful in attracting 40% of competitor's customer. Okay. Matlab, he is gaining 40% new customers from trader A. So this probability is 0.4. Okay. Now we know that row total must be 1. So this must be 0.6. Okay. So this is the transition probability matrix. Ab yahan pe interpretation kaisa hai? See, you may interpret this matrix row wise or column wise. Okay. Now row wise, what it represent? Lose 2. Lost 2. Okay. Means A lost customers to A. Actually, diagonal element represent retention. These are retention probabilities. Okay. A lost 30% customers to B. B lost 40% customer to A. Okay. And अगर आप कॉलम वाइज रीड करते हो तो इसका मीनिंग क्या है? गेन फ्रॉम. ओके, बी गेन्ड 30% कस्टमर्स ऑफ ए. ओके, एंड ए गेन्ड 40% कस्टमर्स ऑफ बी. तो आप इंटरप्रेट कैसे करते हो? अकॉर्डिंगली आपका मैट्रिक्स फॉर्म होगा. ओके, सो बी केयरफुल व्हाइल प्रिपेयरिंग ट्रांजिशन प्रोबेबिलिटी मैट्रिक्स. Because ये इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट है. अगर ये मैट्रिक्स गलत हो गया आपका तो आगे का क्वेश्चन पूरा गलत हो जाएगा. ओके,
कैन यू स्पीक दैट गेन एंड लॉस? इट्स लिटिल बिट कंफ्यूजिंग. गेन और लॉस, कैन यू रिपीट इट?
सी, मैट्रिक्स रीड करना बहुत सिंपल है. पहला रो है ए का, सेकंड रो बी का, सिमिलरली ये कॉलम ए एंड बी. ओके, अब ए टू ए देखो ये क्या है. फर्स्ट रो फर्स्ट कॉलम मतलब ए टू ए. ए टू ए क्या है? 70% है ना. ए इज सक्सेसफुल इन रिटेनिंग 70% कस्टमर. सो ए टू ए हो गया 70 और प्रोबेबिलिटी 0.7. ए टू बी मतलब जो प्रेजेंट स्टेट में ए टू बी, प्रेजेंट स्टेट में ए से कस्टमर परचेस कर रहे, नेक्स्ट स्टेप में बी से परचेस करेंगे, कितने करेंगे? ऐसे 30% कस्टमर से. सो ए टू बी ट्रांजिशन कितना हो गया? 30%. और अगर हम ऐसे प्रोबेबिलिटीज निकालेंगे, ओके, ये हो गया 0.3. रिटेंशन का क्या हो गया?
0.7.
अब बी के लिए क्या है? ए इज गेनिंग 40% कस्टमर्स फ्रॉम बी. तो बी टू ए की प्रोबेबिलिटी हो गई 40%. इट मींस दैट दिस मस्ट बी 60%, 0.6. ओके, तो वही चीज हमने मैट्रिक्स फॉर्म में लिखा है. राइट. तो अगर आप मतलब रो वाइज इंटरप्रिट करोगे मैट्रिक्स को तो क्या है, ये तो हो गई रिटेंशन प्रोबेबिलिटी. ए लूजिंग 30% कस्टमर टू बी, ओके. सिमिलरली बी इज लूजिंग 40% कस्टमर्स टू ए, ओके. अगर कॉलम वाइज रीड करोगे तो ये दो मैट्रिक्स का, ये दो वैल्यूज का रिप्रेजेंट, दिस इज अगेन रिटेंशन प्रोबेबिलिटी, दिस रिप्रेजेंट ए इज गेनिंग 40% कस्टमर फ्रॉम ए, ओके. सी कैसा है, सिंपल लॉजिक है, मतलब सिर्फ पर्सपेक्टिव चेंज हो रहा है यहाँ पे. मींस व्हाट, इफ आई गिव 10 rupees टू से एक्स वाई जेड पर्सन, ओके, इट मींस दैट आई एम लूजिंग ₹10 टू एक्स वाई जेड. ओके, अब मैंने थोड़ा सा पर्सपेक्टिव चेंज किया, फ्रॉम एक्स वाई जेड पर्सन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू ही इज गेनिंग 10 rupees फ्रॉम मी. सेम लॉजिक है यहाँ पे. ओके, अगर हम रो वाइज कंसिडर कर रहे तो क्या है, ए इज लूजिंग 30% कस्टमर टू बी, एंड कॉलम वाइज करेंगे तो, और इसका मतलब क्या है, ए लूजिंग टू बी मीन्स व्हाट, बी इज गेनिंग फ्रॉम ए, करेक्ट. सो पर्सपेक्टिव शिफ्ट चेंज हो रहा है यहाँ पे.
सर एक्चुअली जो रिटेन कर रहे हैं सेम कॉलम में आना चाहिए, जो गेन कर रहे हैं सेम लाइक इन वन कॉलम, और जो लूज कर रहे हैं सो लाइक इन वन कॉलम, ऐसे कंपलसरी है.
इट इज डायगोनली ना सर, रिटेंशन
रिटेंशन डायगोनल होगा. ए 70% रिटेन कर रहा है, मतलब यहां पे 0.7 ए टू ए रिटेन कर रहा है, मतलब क्या है. सी अगर फर्स्ट जनवरी, लेट्स सपोज ऐसा है हमारा, फर्स्ट जनवरी को मैं परचेस कर रहा हूँ फ्रॉम ट्रेडर ए, एंड सेकेंड फेब्रुवरी को भी मैं ट्रेडर ए से परचेस कर रहा हूँ, मतलब क्या हो गया, मैं रिटेन हो गया. ओके, आई एम कंटिन्यूइंग परचेसिंग फ्रॉम ट्रेडर ए इन द नेक्स्ट पीरियड एज वेल. ओके, तो ऐसे कितने कस्टमर्स है मेरे जैसे 70% कस्टमर थे, सपोज 100 कस्टमर्स हम टोटल करते हैं, तो आउट ऑफ 100 70% कस्टमर जिन्होंने जनवरी 1 में ट्रेडर ए से परचेस किया था, वो फेब्रुवरी 1 को भी ट्रेडर ए से ही परचेस कर रहे हैं. एंड जो 30% कस्टमर से जिन्होंने ट्रेडर ए से परचेस किया था इन जनवरी 1, दे आर नाउ परचेसिंग फ्रॉम ट्रेडर बी इन फेब्रुवरी, इन द मंथ ऑफ फेब्रुवरी. ओके, तो ये हो गया लूजिंग, मतलब क्या है, ए ने 30% कस्टमर लूज किए, किसको लूज किए, ए लॉस्ट 30% कस्टमर टू बी. सिमिलरली बी लॉस्ट 40% कस्टमर टू ए. ओके, तो अगर हम कॉलम वाइज रीड करेंगे, इसका मतलब क्या है, ए गेन्ड 40% कस्टमर्स फ्रॉम ए, सॉरी फ्रॉम बी. ओके, बी ने लॉस किया, बी का लॉस मतलब ए का प्रॉफिट हो गया. अब यहाँ पे हमने अज्यूम किया क्या है, दो ही कस्टमर्स है, सॉरी दो ही ट्रेडर्स है मार्केट में. okay. जो मैंने सैमसंग एप्पल का एग्जांपल दिया था उसमें कितने थे, 3 अलग अलग ट्रेडर्स थे, सैमसंग हो गया, एप्पल हो गया, एंड बाकी जो छोटे छोटे ट्रेडर्स है मैंने क्लब कर दिए थे अदर्स में, राइट. सो यहाँ पे ट्रांजिशन हो सकता है फ्रॉम सैमसंग टू अदर, और सैमसंग टू एप्पल, और एप्पल टू सैमसंग एक्सेट्रा विथ सर्टन प्रोबेबिलिटीज, बिकॉज फ्यूचर इज अनसर्टन. अनसर्टेनिटी जो जहां पे आती है वहां पे मॉडल क्या बन जाता है, प्रोबेबिलिस्टिक मॉडल. ओके, तो विद द हेल्प ऑफ दैट प्रोबेबिलिटी वी कैन प्रेडिक्ट फ्यूचर. सो आफ्टर 1 year व्हाट विल बी द मार्केट शेयर ऑफ सैमसंग, और व्हाट विल बी द मार्केट शेयर ऑफ एप्पल, वी कैन एक्चुअली प्रेडिक्ट इफ वी नो द ट्रांजिशन प्रोबेबिलिटीज. फाइन, एक और एग्जाम्पल डिस्कस करते हैं सो दैट आपका आइडिया क्लियर हो जाएगा. सी इन सेकेंड एग्जाम्पल, a small community with 3 types of grocery stores A, B and C, a study was made on January 1 and was found that 1/4 shop at store A, 1/3 at store B and 5/12 at store C. okay. मतलब ये क्या दिया है आपको यहाँ पे, initial condition is given. So what is market share of A? 1/4. Market share of B is 1/3. And market share of C is 5/12. Okay. So this is nothing but initial condition, R0. Okay. जनवरी 1 का स्टेटस उन्होंने दिया है और आई विल राइट इट इन टर्म्स ऑफ परसेंटेज 0.1/4 मतलब 0.25 ये हो गया 0.33 एंड ये 0.48 42 ये हो गया इनिशियल कंडीशन और प्रेजेंट स्टेट फाइन. इसके अलावा क्या दिया है उन्होंने, ईच मंथ स्टोर ए रिटेन्स 90% कस्टमर्स एंड लूजेस 10% टू स्टोर बी. नाउ आई विल राइट ट्रांजिशन स्टेट प्रोबेबिलिटी मैट्रिक्स. स्टोर ए स्टोर बी स्टोर सी ए बी सी. नाउ ए इज सक्सेसफुल इन रिटेनिंग 90% कस्टमर सो रिटेंशन प्रोबेबिलिटी फॉर स्टोर ए इज 0.9. ए इज लूजिंग 10% कस्टमर्स टू बी. ओके एंड ए इज नॉट लूजिंग एनी कस्टमर टू सी, मतलब ये प्रोबेबिलिटी हो गई 0. ओके व्हाट अबाउट स्टोर बी, स्टोर बी रिटेन्स 85% of its customers and loses 5% and 10% to store A and C. This probability is 0.05. This is 0.85 and 0.1. Okay. See, B is successful in retaining 85% customer. So retention probability is 0.85 for store B. B is losing 5% to A. So this probability is 0.05. And B is losing 10% to C. So this probability is 0.1. And what about C? Store C retains only 40% of the customers. Okay. The retention probability for C is 40%. And loses 50% to store A. C loses 50% to A and 10% to B. Okay. Now we want to calculate the proportion of customers will each store retain by February 1 and March 1. Okay. मतलब यहाँ पे period लिया है 1 month का. Okay. Now R0 is given. Initial condition is R0, which is given to us. We want to calculate state probabilities for next period and next to next period. मतलब R1 February 1 में क्या होगी state? So R1 is R0 into P. Now what is R0? So we'll substitute the value 0.25, 0.33, 0.42 multiplied by transition state probability 0.9, 0.10, 0.05, 0.85, 0.1, 0.5, 0.1, 0.4. See, order of R0 is 1/3 and transition probability matrix ki order hai 3/3. So here number of columns in R0 is 3, number of rows of matrix P is 3. So matrix multiplication is possible over here. And what would be the order of matrix?
3/3.
Order of product 1/3. Okay, see, ye common hai na? Ye same hai. So order is 1/3, right? कैसे करना है, ये रो वाइज जाना है और यहाँ पे कॉलम वाइज जाना है, राइट? तो 0.5 इंटू 0.9, 0.25 इंटू 0.9 प्लस 0.33 इंटू 0.05 प्लस 0.42 इंटू 0.5. ओके नेक्स्ट एलिमेंट अभी थोड़ा सा बड़ा हो जाएगा. ओके दिस इज एक्चुअली फर्स्ट एलिमेंट है से ए वन वन, उसके बाद आपका 812 आएगा. नेक्स्ट एलिमेंट क्या होगा, एल राइट 0.25 इनटू 0.1 प्लस 0.33 इनटू 0.85 प्लस 0.42 इनटू 0.1. ओके, एंड थर्ड एलिमेंट 0.25 इनटू 0 प्लस 0.33 इनटू 0.1 प्लस 0.42 इनटू 0.4. ओके, सो दिस कम्स आउट टू बी, यहाँ पे मैंने सॉल्यूशन दिया है. ओके, सो इट इज इक्वल टू 0.4515, 0.3475 and 0.201. Okay. Okay. Similarly, अगर मार्च 1 का हमें निकालना है, मतलब after 2 periods, R2 calculate करना है, तो R2 is what?
R1 into P.
Okay. R1 हमने यहाँ पे calculate किया है, तो ये हम यहाँ पे substitute करेंगे. 0.4515 0.3475 and 0.201. Okay. देखो कैलकुलेशन. कम्स आउट टू बी ओके आर वन इज दिस. आर टू इज 0.524, 0.361, 0.115. Okay. Now, what was R0? एक मिनट, आर जीरो क्या था, 0.25, 0.33 एंड 0.42. ओके, let's see, if you observe these state probabilities, okay, initial state, state one probabilities, state two probabilities, etc. okay, ab yahan pe dekho change kya ho gaya, agar store one consider karenge yahan pe kitna ekdam se 0.2 change hua hai, right? Here change is of 0. Approximately equal to 0.07. okay, नेक्स्ट स्टेप में आप जाओगे, इफ यू कैलकुलेट आर थ्री, देन यू विल फाइंड दैट द मार्केट शेयर ऑफ स्टोर ए इज इंक्रीज लिटिल बिट, बट नॉट द इंक्रीज विल बी लेस देन 0.07. ओके, यहाँ पे भी देखो स्टोर बी का भी इंक्रीज हो रहा है, यहाँ पे ऑलमोस्ट 0.175 इंक्रीज हुआ है एंड यहाँ पे 0.125 इंक्रीज हुआ है. ओके, वेयर एज स्टोर सी इज लूजिंग कस्टमर, यहाँ पे दोनों गेन कर रहे हैं, स्टोर ए एंड स्टोर बी इज गेनिंग द कस्टमर व्हाइल स्टोर बी इज स्टोर सी इज लूजिंग कस्टमर्स. ओके, फर्स्ट मंथ में यहाँ पे लॉस बहुत ज्यादा हो गया, राइट, ऑलमोस्ट 20% कस्टमर का लॉस हो गया, यहाँ पे 9% का लॉस हो गया, राइट. सो मतलब यहाँ पे इसका लॉस भी जो डिफरेंस है और द लॉस if we compare successive months, here loss is comparatively reducing. Here also, gain from one state to another state is comparatively reducing. So if you continue this process, then after some periods, you will find that change is not significant. Okay, maybe R10 or R15 तक आप जाओगे. तो इसमें जो मार्केट शेयर में जो चेंजेस आएगा वो इतना सिग्निफिकेंट रहने का ऑलमोस्ट सेम होगा और द चेंज विल बी निग्लिजिबल. सो दैट सिचुएशन इज कॉल्ड एज स्टेडी स्टेट प्रोबेबिलिटीज. ओके, वो कंसेप्ट मैंने यहाँ पे नोट्स में दिया है, डेफिनेशन दिया है, बट विद द हेल्प ऑफ एग्जाम्पल आई वॉन्टेड टू एक्सप्लेन. सो दैट इज वाई मैंने थोड़ा सा उस वक्त स्किप किया. सी यू कैन ऑब्जर्व यहाँ पे चेंजेस आप कैलकुलेट करोगे, डिफरेंसेस. यहाँ पे चेंज ज्यादा है कंपेयर टू यहाँ पे कम है. आप R3 निकालोगे तो भी चेंज और कम होता जाएगा. ओके, वेदर इट इज इंक्रीजिंग और डिक्रीजिंग, जो चेंज इन द मार्केट शेयर है वो आपका रिड्यूस होते जाएगा. सो आफ्टर सम फाइनाइट नंबर ऑफ पीरियड्स यू विल फाइंड दैट द स्टेट प्रोबेबिलिटीज ऑफ टू सक्सेसिव पीरियड इज ऑलमोस्ट सेम. ओके, और द डिफरेंस बिटवीन टू सक्सेसिव स्टेट प्रोबेबिलिटीज इज निग्लिजिबल. So this situation is called as steady state probabilities. Okay, मतलब क्या है कि आपका जो market है it has reached to saturation stage. Okay, जैसे अभी see Jio की entry हुई in telecom sector, before the entry of Jio the market share of operators, अलग अलग ऑपरेटर्स थे, आइडिया वॉज देयर, देन एयरटेल, वोडाफोन, देन टाटा इंडिकॉम वॉज देयर, डोकोमो वॉज देयर, ओके, वेरियस प्लेयर्स वेर देयर इन द मार्केट. तो सबका मार्केट शेयर ऑलमोस्ट सेम था, सक्सेसिव आप स्टेबल था. ओके, द मार्केट वॉज स्टेबल. ओके, उसके बाद क्या हुआ, जियो की एंट्री हो गई टेलीकॉम सेक्टर में, उसने पूरा सिस्टम डिस्टर्ब कर दिया. ओके, नाउ सी आफ्टर सम years you will find that the market share of Jio or Vodafone Idea, Airtel will remain same for two successive periods. Okay, so ye saturation stage pe aaya tha. Before Jio's entry the market were in saturation stage, but Jio ne pura dynamics hi change kar diye. Okay, now agar aap successive period discuss karoge, if you compare the market share of different telecom companies in the telecom sector, you will find that jo difference between two successive shares of two successive periods of different companies wo dheere dheere kam ho raha hai. Okay, initially dekho Jio ne ekdam pick up liya, zero se direct number of millions usne switch kiya. Okay, while it has gained customers from Airtel, then Tata Indicom, Tata Docomo, etc. Same situation is यहाँ पे भी वही हो रहा है. देखो यहाँ पे क्या हो रहा है, here we have assumed that there are only three players in the market, A, B and C. यहाँ पे A is gaining. In the first month, the gain of A is significant. Almost 20% customers उसने gain किए. यहाँ पे वही gain कम हो गया, 7% आ गया. Here also 0.0175 इसका इंक्रीज है यहाँ से यहाँ तक. यहाँ पर वो इंक्रीज कंपेरेटिवली कम हो गया. ओके, 125 है. हियर आल्सो लॉस इज ऑलमोस्ट 22%. यहाँ पे वो लॉस काफी कम हो गया, 9% आ गया. सो अगर आप कंटिन्यू करेंगे आगे R3 और R4, R5, R6, R10, ओके, यू विल फाइंड दैट द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द मार्केट शेयर of these three traders in successive periods is very negligible. So aisa situation jab aayega usko hum kya consider karte, we call it as steady state probabilities. Okay, yahan pe successive periods mein state probabilities mein negligible difference hota hai ya nahi hota hai. So this situation is called as steady state probability. Okay, I think is unit ka जो थेरेटिकल पार्ट है जो मुझे एक्सप्लेन करना था, तो आई एम डन विथ माय एक्सप्लेनेशन. कुछ एग्जांपल्स आई हैव गिवन सम एग्जांपल्स ओवर हियर, तो आप ट्राई करो, ज्यादा डिफिकल्ट नहीं है. इसमें थोड़ा सा एग्जाम्पल नंबर सिक्स थोड़ा सा ट्रिकी है. So we'll discuss example number six and then we'll wind up this topic. Okay. So example number six kya hai? Assume that there are only three social networking sites, Face, Link and Tweet. Initially, a sample of 1,000 people who uses these sites, it's collected. Due to multiple reasons, people used to shift from one site to another. Initially, 25% people use Face, 45% people use Link, and 30% people use Tweet. Okay. Matlab, out of 10,000, if we calculate the number, so Face, Link, and Tweet. 25% of 1,000 is 250. Link ke kitne hai?
45%
मतलब 450 लिंक के हैं एंड रिमेनिंग दैट इज 300 ट्वीट के, राइट? और इन टर्म्स ऑफ प्रोबेबिलिटी, सो आर जीरो अगर हम कंसीडर करेंगे तो क्या होगा, 0.25, 0.45 एंड 0.3. ओके, दिस इज इनिशियल कंडीशन. फाइन, नाउ इट इज गिवन दैट Face loses 25 customers to Link and 30 customers to Tweet. Okay. अब यहाँ पे जो figures जो दिए, these are not actually probabilities. वो percentage में नहीं दिया है. It is given in numbers. Okay. मतलब क्या है? Face is losing 25 to Link and 30 to Tweet. Means in total, it is losing 55 customers. Okay, 55 customers out of 250. Okay, it means that Face is successful in retaining 195 customers. Okay, 195 out of 250. Okay, ye samajh mein aa raha hai? Face has lost 25 customers to Link and 30 customers to Tweet. See, अब previous example में direct probabilities दी थी, यहाँ पे आपको probabilities calculate करनी पड़ेंगी, right? Here, the loss or gain is given in numbers, not in percentage or not in probabilities. Okay, तो हमें यहाँ पे actually calculate करना पड़ेगा. तो ये क्या हो गया? What this percentage would be? देखो 195 डिवाइड बाय 250 कितना था, तो आई प्रिपेयर अ मैट्रिक्स.
0.78
मतलब फेस की रिटेंशन प्रोबेबिलिटी कितनी, 0.78 लिंक एंड ट्वीट. ओके, हम रो वाइज जाएंगे, राइट? नाउ फेस इज लूजिंग 25 कस्टमर्स टू लिंक. So what is percentage loss? 25 out of 250, that is 10%. Okay, right? Or 0.1. Got it? So Face lost 10% to Link, and it has lost 30 out of 250 to Tweet. So ye kitna aayega? This would be 0.12. Got it? Theek hai, ye samajh mein aa gaya probabilities kaise calculate kiye maine? See, hame yahan pe probabilities nikalna hai on the basis of the existing customers. Okay, now there are 250 existing customers for Face, out of which 25 are lost to Link. So 25 loss of 25 in comparison with 250, so wo loss kitna ho gaya? 10% का लॉस, राइट। सिमिलरली अभी हम क्या करेंगे, इसके लिए कैलकुलेट करेंगे फॉर लिंक एंड क्विट। नाउ लिंक इज लूजिंग 40 कस्टमर्स टू फेस एंड 30 कस्टमर्स टू ट्विट। ओके, सो ये प्रोबेबिलिटी कितनी होगी, 40 आउट ऑफ 450, राइट। सो 40 आउट ऑफ 450, I'll write this directly, 40 out of 450 and 30 out of 450 to tweet. So it means that Link is successful in retaining 450 minus 70, that is 380. Okay. 380 out of 450. राइट, तो देखो कैलकुलेट करके देखो प्रोबेबिलिटी क्या आ रही। सिमिलरली ट्वीट का क्या होगा, इट इज लूजिंग 25 कस्टमर्स डिवाइड बाय 300, ओके, देन 30 डिवाइड बाय 300 एंड ये क्या होगा, सॉरी तो 55 मतलब 245 डिवाइड बाय 300, ओके। So this is the required transition probability matrix. Okay. अब यहाँ पे कुछ calculate करने के लिए नहीं बोला है, but even if you want to calculate the customers of these three social networking sites after one period, तो आपका R0 हो गया है यहाँ पे, R0 is 0.25, 0.45, 0.3. So R1 के लिए क्या करना है, R0 into P, R2 के लिए R1 into P and so on. तो यहाँ पे कुछ पूछा नहीं उन्होंने कैलकुलेट करने के लिए, बट ठीक है, ओके। इसमें कोई डाउट
सर? जो गेन्ड फ्रॉम जो है वो table actually, अगर if you check it would be verified, right? I mean as in
जरूरत नहीं है, अगर इससे करेंगे तो भी चलेगा।
I mean either or, हाँ
हाँ either, right? Okay, so I think इस topic में ज़्यादा कुछ नहीं, इतना ही है, easy topic है, ठीक है। Next session में हम क्या करेंगे, we'll start a new topic. Tomorrow and day after tomorrow, I'll be busy in Viva's examination. University, as per the directives given by Supreme Court, university has started examination, okay? And Viva's examination for dissertation is scheduled in our college on 19th of this month, the day after tomorrow, for passing out batch, okay, not aapke liye nahi hai wo, so that I'll be busy day after tomorrow in our college, Viva's examination of our students, and tomorrow I'm going as an external examiner for in other college, so tomorrow and day after tomorrow I'll not be able to conduct session, so we'll meet in the next week, okay, so next week mein hum naya topic start karenge. तो बाय दैट टाइम आप ये प्रैक्टिस करो,
ओके सर, ओके ओके, नो प्रॉब्लम।
सो कल टुमारो एंड आफ्टर टुमारो देयर विल बी नो लेक्चर ऑफ माइन, ना परसों तो कोई भी सब लोग बिजी रहेंगे, मतलब सैटरडे को कोई भी लेक्चर नहीं हो पाएगा, बाकी स्टाफ कल लेक्चर कंडक्ट करेंगे,
ओके सर, ओके ओके, थैंक यू सर।